are only four going, four crews, so we're talking from a gentle build up to the A final. We're in one line.
This moment is number three from Canada, Ryan Cochran in Munich Games.
His father came from our panel in Montreal in 76. Sadly died there in Munich
Games. In line lane number four from Denmark.
His father's racing shirt in the book with him this week. Neil Starr and Kim Ray, they would be very disappointed not to be in their final half of the very strong Danish K4. Evgeny Alexeyev and Alexey Dergunov.
1 minute to the start, gentlemen, they brought this top.
And then Kallenberg and Lohan Panikov. B final in the men's K2.
Line 6 forward, please.
Denmark, Kazakhstan.
6 forward.
Belgium and 6 just been told to come forward a little bit into the bucket. They're not moving at the moment, just edging forward.
Lane 6 forward, thank you.
And Belgium, the B final.
Ready?
K2, 1,000.
Set.
There goes the point stop.
Boom, boom, here we go, everybody. This is our fifth match of the 1,000 meters.
Closing down, but Denmark hang on to take victory here in this B final. Canada coming through in fourth.
These B-finals can be a real challenge for the athletes. Like, how do they get themselves mentally prepared for it? Are they fed up with not making it into the A-final? I'm sure they will be very disappointed. But it's getting their mindset. Do they want to claim that first spot to show that they should have been in that final? For the Danish pair we see here in our screen, I'm using it as almost a warm-up for tomorrow's K4. Timing here, spot on.
Ray and Star take ninth place in this event after winning this B final. We have confirmation of the result. The Belgian Belgium, bringing up the field in this rather abbreviated lineup in the B final. Star is going. Celebrations, congratulations from one to another. Again, they go in the K4, a nice strong Danish boat there.
The first kayaks, well, they were fashioned out of driftwood and animal skins by the natives of the Arctic regions of Asia, North America, and Greenland. Flatwater canoeing featured in the 1924 Games as a demonstration sport before the sprint
and
officially ended the Olympics in
1936.
The most famous of all is German Birgit Fischer. She won an incredible 8 goals and 4 silvers in 1980 and 2004. She really
involved. We prepared ourselves for the A final.
These potions being carried off to go to boat way and go to appropriate checks, make sure they're legal.
And talking about smart boys. We have now lined up the 8 best crews in the kayak double 1,000 meter men gold medal race.
Please stand to the start line
in
your lane.
In the K2 1,000 meters A final to decide
all
the medals.
Come to the start line, please.
In
your
lane.
And Donald Fitzgerald, Stephen Ferguson, New Zealand pair, Ferguson, 32, 10 years. Fitzgerald Senior. Yeah, Medvedev from Anton Maryakov of Russia. A regular World Cup finalist this year, bronze medalist at the World Championships 2 years ago.
In lane number 3,
Sweden. And Marcus Oskarsson from Sweden.
Oh,
God, Dave Smith and Ken Wallace. Wallace, the Queenslanders, the K1 500 meters Olympic champion. The back end is taking has been scrapped. And Fernando Pimenta and Manuel Silva of Portugal. He scored in the World Cup event in Poznan a couple of months ago. But in here, look out for Martin Holstein and Andreas Iller of Germany. And the Hungarian pair of Rudolf Dombey and Roland Kilkenny. The Hungarians are the European champions this year, the quickest in qualifying. One they heat avoided the semi-finals. Holstein and Iller in lane 5. Silver and last in June's European Championships behind Dombey and Kilkenny. And they were the winners of this event in Beijing 4 years ago. Great noise from the support. The lineup: New Zealand, Russia, Sweden, Hungary, Dombey, Kilkenny, Germany, with Holstein and Iller, Slovakia, Peter Geller, and Erik Karcek, Estonia, and Portugal, the final of the men's K2 1,000 meters. Holstein, Iller, Dombey, Kilkenny, Germany, Hungary, Kilkenny, Spain.
They're beginning to pick up the pace as well. We thought it might be between Hungary and Germany. It may well prove to be the case, but still going well. Pimenta and Silva down at the bottom of the picture. They're in third place at the moment. It is between Hungary and Germany as we speak at the moment, and as they come into the final 50 metres, it is so close. Dombey and Kikini holding on at the moment and holding off the Germans. The line is coming for them. Dombey and Kikini for the line for the gold, and the Portuguese get the silver ahead of the Germans. Pimenta and Silva take it, with Holstein and Ille taking the bronze. But Rudolf Dombey and Roland Kikini, European champions, now Olympic champions. Portugal coming through so well for the silver there. A surprise from Rainey taking it ahead of Holstein and Ille. But the Hungarians shattered, but they will celebrate, and they took the applause and the acclaim from Holstein and Ille, who I thought were coming back, but didn't have it, and they have the bronze. A slight push it was indeed from Portugal, almost slipping through to take the gold. They take the crown off Holstein Miller, who had won the gold medal in this event in Beijing 4 years ago. Rudolf Dombey and Roland Kikini, the gold medalist. Our first photo finish of the day, just to confirm. Dombey and Kikini from Hungary ahead of Fernando Pimenta, and then a silver Portugal, and the bronze medal going to the champions 4 years ago in Beijing. Martin Holstein and Andres Ille of Germany.
That was fantastic. It was tight. A number of boats in there. The Swedes really pushed it out. They just get themselves up there, but they just couldn't hold on when the real challenge came from the Hungarians. It was working together. How key it is to actually get that time.